Hi guys, welcome back to our channel, and today we're going to be doing a glitter ombre full acrylic set. Stay tuned and see how I do this set. First, I'm starting off with filing my nails to make sure that they remove all the shininess from them, and then I will start gluing on the nail tips. To get those clippers and just start trimming my nails so that they are shorter, and then I start to glue on the nail tips. But let me tell you, I had some problems gluing on these nail tips. I had several different glues that I was using to try to get these nail tips on, but they would not stay at all for some reason. So I got probably each glue to work at least once, but no other time. But the end result, I had to use super glue to get the nail tips to stay. And when you actually see me using the acrylic, some of the nail tips pop up and I stick acrylic underneath of them. So I really was struggling with the glue. I guess all my glue that I have is dried up and does not adhere anymore. So I apologize for that. But I do get them glued on, and then once I glue them on, I will get started with the acrylic process. Now I am applying the primer to my nail and just the outline of the nail tip where it's adhering to my nail. And then I start off with the pink acrylic. It's not pink acrylic. It's pink monomer. And I show that in my last video. I'll link it here. And that's what I'm using for the cuticle area or the nail bed area. And then on the tips, that's where I'm going to apply the glitter and the clear powder. So this is the struggle that I said the nail tip was lifting up, and I have to stick acrylic underneath of it to put it back down. It was just a real struggle. I don't know why. Sorry about that. But if you like this type of content, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. Let me know you're here, what things you like to see. And we'll just continue with this glitter, because glitter always makes everything look so pretty. Here I am getting a ball of clear acrylic, and then I'm dipping it into the glitter, and then I place it on the tip of the nail, and then I fan it out and place the acrylic glitter in the way that I want it to be. Now I finished the glitter ombre on the tips, and I know you're probably like, why is she cutting them? So I finished that hand and I had to leave to go to an appointment. And when I was at the appointment and I was looking at my nails, and I thought they were so cute and everything, but then I was like, these are too long for me. So I came back home and I decided to cut them. And also I did not encapsulate them before the appointment because I was running late. So here you're seeing me encapsulate the acrylic and the glitter of the nails so that they are finished, and I cut them to the length that I wanted. But then also you'll see later that I decided to change the shape of them too. I just couldn't decide what I wanted. So this is me, how I do things. I just change my mind as I'm going. and drilling and buffing. Actually, no, I'm not doing any buffing. But I'm doing all this because I'm deciding to change the shape of the nail at the last minute. I want it to be more coffin shaped and gel top coat. So this is my first time trying it, and I will say that since I've had these nails on now for like 2 weeks, the shine has stayed completely. It dried in no time, so I actually did like it, and I'll probably continue using it. Now I'm gonna have to try it on my natural nail to see if it works that well for my natural nails. And this is me showing you how I did the other hand, which I did later that day. As you can tell, my clothes have changed. I'm doing that hand later in the day, and I got a new thing of super glue, and you can see my nails are gluing correctly and they're staying on. So this is the way that I should have done my nails. You will see that I do create the shape of the coffin in the beginning, and I correct my length in the beginning as well, and that's the correct way to actually do them. But I will also point out, when you see me doing the shaping of the coffin, that next time I'll probably do it before I glue the tips to my nails, because I'm not left-handed, so it was kind of difficult for me to cut the correct angles with the scissors. The glitter application on this one, I put acrylic top coat on the tip of the nail, and then I poured the glitter over top of it, and it gave it a different effect, I feel like, when I did it that way, and it was easier for me to encapsulate. But here are the final results. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.